Good morning to everyone. Myself, Sri Lakshmi, PGT Mathematics from TSWRS in Murthy. Children, can you imagine the world without mathematics? Obviously, the answer is no, because we cannot imagine the world without mathematics. Mathematics is involved in numbers. Children, do you know who is the father of mathematics in the world? Yes. Archimedes is known as the father of mathematics in the world. Look at this slide. He is the father of mathematics in the world. He discovered many things in the mathematics and he is a Greek mathematician. Children, do you know how many branches we have in mathematics? We have different branches in mathematics like number theory, algebra, geometry, mensuration. So today what we are going to discuss the topic, it is also one of the important branch of mathematics, that is called as statistics. The objectives of today's class is, students will be able to learn, understand the basic statistical concepts, differentiate the types of data, know the methods of analysis of the data, and explain primary and secondary resources. Derived from the Latin word status, or the Italian word statistica. The word statistics is derived from the Latin word status or the Italian word statistica. The meaning of these two words is a political party. A political party. Or a government. Or a government. Children, do you know who is the father of modern statistics? Yes, look at this slide. Father of modern statistics, Sir Ronald Fisher. He discovered many things in statistics and he is a British mathematician. He is known as the father of modern statistics. Children, do you know who is the father of Indian statistics? Yes. P.C. Mahalanobis is known as father of Indian statistics. Look at this slide. He is known as father of Indian statistics, P.C. Mahalanobis. Our former Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, in his honor, he announced that June 29, 2018 as a National Statistics Day. Former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, he announced that June 29th, 2018 as National Statistics Day. So what is statistics? Statistics deals with today, what is the population, how much population we have, and how much food required today in the society, and what is the literacy rate. How many women are there? How many men are there? How many adults are there? So if you want to know all these things, so we require statistics. For example, if you take a school, how many students are there? How many teachers are there? What is the pass percentage in the 10th class? So how many benches are there? So if you want to know all these things, we require the statistics. So the statistics deals with mainly three concepts. They are the collection of data, look at this slide children, collection of data, analysis of the data, and decision making. So the statistics deals with the main three major concepts. They are collection of data, analysis of the data, and decision making. First, when we go to the collection of data, what is meant by collection of data? What is mean by collection of data? What is mean by data? So data is the plural of datum. Datum is a singular and the plural of datum is data. Data is the plural. So what is mean by data? The definition of data is the collection of information in the form of facts or in the numbers. The collection of information in the form of facts or numbers. For example, if you want to know the information about the marks scored by the 10th class students in mathematics, so you have to ask the children how many marks they scored, how many marks they scored. Randomly we will collect the information from the student. So the collection of information in the form of facts or in the figures is called as the data. So here we have two types of data. They are raw data and group data. So what is mean by raw data? Raw data is also called as primary data. If you collect the data, if you collect the information without any specific order, randomly, then it is called as raw data. If you collect the information without any specific order, then it is called as the raw data or the primary data. So, look at this slide. Yeah, this is the example for the raw data. So, these are the marks of the students scored in mathematics. Randomly collected from the students and I posted in a paper. So, like 33, 31, 28. There is no specific order for this data. So, this kind of data is known as raw data. Next, coming to the next, group data. So, what is mean by group data? If the data is analysis into different classes or in convenient groups, then it is called as group data. So, if you after collecting the information, if you make the data into different groups, then it is comes under the group data. If you look at this slide here, some of the marks of the students in mathematics from 0 to 30, there is a 30 marks, there is one child. From 30 to 40 marks, there are 5 children. And 40 to 50 marks, there are 5 students. And 50 to 60, there are 4 students. This kind of data is known as group data. So to collect the data here, we have majorly two resources. One is primary resources and the other one is secondary resources. So what are the primary resources? First we look at that. Primary resources. So in primary resources, we have majorly three methods. Number one, questionnaire method. Number two, interview method. And number three is mailing method. So look at this slide, children. If you look at this, you will get an idea what is a questionnaire. See, for example, to collect the information from a person, first we will frame some questions to ask the person. So the first picture, it shows that questionnaire method. Next, coming to the second picture, interview method, either orally or personally or a written way. So this is the example for the interview method. Next, the third one is mailing method. Nowadays the technology was improved a lot, so to collect the information, so we are referring many Google apps. So from mailing or from the WhatsApp, we are getting the information easily. Next, coming to the secondary resources. Secondary resources. So earlier records, earlier history. So already the history was founded. Already the history was recorded by some of the people comes under the secondary resources. So, if you look at this slide, we have different secondary resources. They are organizational records, diary, books and journals, and pictorial representation, and government publications, and website pages. Here we have different secondary resources where we get the information from different records or from the different technical groups. Okay, next. Coming to the second concept of the statistics, that is analysis of the data. Analysis of the data. So, to analyze the data, we have three basic measures of central tendency. So, they are mean, mode and median. By using these three measures, we can find out, we can analyze the data easily. That we will discuss in the next class. Now, the third one is decision making. Decision making. After collecting the data, whether it is true or false, the thing is possible or not, whether it is right or wrong. So, to get a common conclusion after analyzing the data, by depending on the result, we will take a decision. We will take a decision. So, the main three concepts of the basic idea of the statistics, they are collection of data, analysis of the data and decision making. The statistics main deals with all these three concepts. Thank you.